As we have discussed the next category of the industries, see here, we have discussed about the agro-based industries. Now, if the minerals are the raw materials, then we call them as mineral-based industries. Iron and steel are the basic industry because most of the industries, it may be small, medium, high industries, all come under or require the investment of iron and steel. That is the reason why iron and steel industry is known as basic industry, which is required for all categories of industries. Now let us see here, iron and steel, the conventional sources of energy in the geographical location of India, you find it at various places. And India is abundantly filled with the minerals and rich in the mineral contents. And you can see the iron and steel being the basic sources of energy or requirement of every industry. At the same time, it also needs the conventional energy like coal, gas, and petroleum, which provides the sources of energies to run the industries. Now let us move on towards the iron and steel industry. As it is a basic industry, from steel you can make various kinds of products. It may be electronic products, usable products of medicine products, then you have the application products of what we use in the day-to-day uses, utensil products, all these things, not only in one sector, electronics, manufacturing, making of the products, everything you need is steel products. Even in the aeroplane manufacturing industries also, you need in some places the aluminium, iron to be mixed for that. So, iron and steel industries are called basic industries because they are used for many other industries as a raw or basic sources. Now, when we take the content of iron ore, cooking coal and the limestone added for 4:2:1 ratio, then they provide a strong element which is required for them to make the products. And if you see, India produced 32.8 million tons of the production, and India stands in the 9th place of the production of the iron and steel. But still, if it comes to using of iron, India is famous for producing sponge iron, and 32 kgs only is the average per capita usage of iron in Indian context. So still it has to be improved. When we move on our focus towards the aluminium sector, the aluminium is a product which is having the basic good qualities like light. It is very light in weight, it is corrosion and it gets connected very easily. It is a very good connector of heat and it is a malleable which is accessible to the other minerals also, and it makes alloys very soon. We have nearly 8 aluminium plants in Odisha at Nalka and Balka, West Bengal, Kerala, UP, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and all the other regions. And in 2004, it has produced 600 million tons of aluminium. And for producing of aluminium, aluminium is mainly used in making of the aircraft industries also because they are very light in weight. And the basic sources which are required for making aluminium is the bauxite. Bauxite is a mineral which is very needed in very bulky for aluminium industries, and it is in the reddish rock state of color which is need to burn the aluminium to make it into the exact forms. And we need the continuous supply of electricity which is required for us to run the industries. These two are the major factors to make aluminium industries to set up. And when we move on to the chemical industries are adding 3% of the entire GDP of India. And in India, we have the growing growth of chemical industries. The categorization of chemical industries are again done into organic chemicals and the inorganic chemicals. The organic chemicals are the industries that are having synthetic, rubber, plastic and drugs. The inorganic chemical industries are sulfur, nitric acid, alkalis and the soda ash. In this categorization of the industries, and we have seen industrial growth is very much required for a country like India where the basic industries are required, then we need the other industrial units like aluminium and the chemical industries where the number of people can get the employed and where the availability of the raw materials obviously makes the place get accessible to it and get it to flourish as an industrial location. Let us find out, what about the fertilizers? What about the automobile engineering or automobile industries? So moving on to the fertilizer industries. The fertilizers are mainly industries which are located at the places where we get the nitrogen, phosphate and potash. As you all know, nitrogen and phosphate are available in large forests, but potash, we need to get everything from the outside. It is the third largest import what we are getting entirely from outside. And India stands very good in large production of the nitrogenous fertilizers. India has nearly 57 units of these fertilizing units, and in these fertilizer units you have 29 urea units, 9 the ammonium sulfate units which also produce for us, and 68 small and large single sulfur phosphate units, and we have 10 public undertakings and 1 fertilizer corporation of India units. And India has been developing very fast in the production of the fertilizer industries, because India needs fertilizers. At the same time, India is exporting also the fertilizers to the other nations, and many of these places where we have the fertilizers are located in the North Indian regions. And moving on to the cement building industry, for in order to build anything, we need cement. Any building, any house, any office, any road, any bricks, any kind of bridges, everything, we need the construction of cement. So cement production is highly required in India. The first cement plant was established in Chennai in 1904, but till the later part of India gets independence and focus shifted towards the development of cement or the infrastructure of majorly, in 1989 the policy has changed and firmly brought the development of the cement industry in the larger scale. And today we have 128 large and 332 minimum cement plants which are producing for us, and the cement production is very high in India. And India achieved in the good production of exports, especially Indian cement is exported to Asia, Middle East, East Asia, Middle East, Africa and South Asia, and is exported to many other countries. There are plans to bring the internal demands for the sustainable growth and to build the local market for the cement so that it can be added for the local needs also. But let's hope it will be added for both exports and import, and cement industry will have a bright future. And next, moving on to the automobile industries. The automobiles are the latest trends of growing very fast. Earlier the automobile industries are in very less percentage and they were not at all in the reach of either cement or fertilizers or the IT industries. But today the automobile industries have developed very fast in the last 15 years. That too after the FDIs, the foreign direct investments, have entered into this one, they have increased rapidly. Today we have 15 automobile maker industries and 9 commercial value industries or commercial vehicle industries, and 14 two or three wheeler units. These all are located in Delhi, Mumbai, Pune, Kolkata, Chennai, Lucknow, Patna and all these various places. And these are contributing a lot, because nowadays everybody is able to own a vehicle of his own, either it may be two wheeler, three wheeler or it may be a four wheeler, depending on their economic status. So the automobile industry is the fastest growing industry because of the need of the humans to transport from one place to another place. Nowadays even for offices they are going by the two wheelers is common, and even four wheelers also has become a common scenario nowadays. Moving on to the IT and the electronics industry. IT and electronics contribute a lot for us. They fall under the category of producing transistors, TVs, cell phones, radios, radar units, all these things. And with the growth of various industries at Bangalore, the Silicon Valley, the Bangalore has become the electronic capital of India, and it has 18 software technological parks which provide the software output solutions for the entire nation and the other nations. And this IT industry has tremendously brought the employment opportunities to the people, and nearly 1 million people are getting employed in this one, and this is going to increase in the next 3-4 years 8-fold times, which is a very large growth for us. And we also get foreign exchange in huge revenue for us because of the BPO services which are given by this IT and the electronic industries. So in this way the industries are covering for us a large and wider scale of the prospective, and they are bringing a major contribution for us in the development of the nation. Now, what is the industrial policy of India? We'll find out.